the time and try to impress people on how good they are because they can yell and blame a horse. I'm going to put this over his leg, but he may kick out, so I got to be careful. Look out, bud. Get out of my face. Quit. Okay, good. So now this is over his head, and I'm going to get on that butt. His tail's clenched. I can tell that tail is clamped right now. He's sending me signals. I'm nervous. He's sweating. He's tired because I wore him out. So right now, he's learned that it's easier to stand here and take this. When I first came out here, it was easier to run. I don't want that rope on me. I'll just run. So he did about 100 laps around here, and I just kept throwing a rope. And then he figured out, you know what? It's a little easier to stand here and let you do this. Didn't get in a fight. Didn't get mad at him. It was all part of the process. Training is a process, it's not an event. That's why when people write me questions and want to give me this real quick answer about, hey, can you fix this? Can you tell me this? I don't have time for that, okay? Because you're looking for training to be an event. And training is a process. It's not an event. It's time. It's learning to read your horse. It's learning what scares him. It's learning how to read when he's scared. See that horse's ears? Look at his ears on his legs. See, he's looking at something else right now, which is good. I want him to pay attention to other things. I don't want him to pay attention to this rope. See, he's glancing around. This rope is all over his butt. I ain't stop moving this rope. Now I'm going to give him a little bit of release here because I've been moving it and talking and yapping and not paying attention. I want him to know standing still is the right answer, so I have to release the pressure. If I just do this till he moves, he'll learn to move. So I want to move and I want to stop. I want to wiggle, create pressure, desensitize. He stood still and stop. Pretty soon he'll figure out, you know what? This rope ain't such a bad thing. Man, if you saw this horse when I first got this rope out, he was reared and kicking and trying to bite the other guy. But now, we're getting it over his back, and I'm going to go ahead and throw it on that side, and it's going to hang, and it snapped him under his belly, and I'm going to walk around front of him. Good boy, bud. I've got to be careful this guy's back legs, because if this little guy bites him, he'll kick me not wanting to. Hi, bud. Hi, are you scared? Look at those ears. He's nervous, very submissive. Look at that head drop. Look at that head drop nice and low, saying, hey, dude, you win. I'm tired of running. See, I couldn't get that rope to touch him probably 20 minutes ago. And now that he got all his piss and vinegar out of him running this grass, he learned, man, you know what? This guy ain't so bad. This rope ain't so bad. But I had to create fear. I had to make him move. And I had to show him that the right answer is not running. That's a big mistake that people make. When a horse resists or says no, the person says, oh, I better stop. I don't want to get him hurt. He might hurt himself. I don't know what I'm doing. When you stop, you teach the horse that's the right answer. Then he learns how to get you to stop things. And the more things he gets you to stop, the more he learns that you're lower, you're stupid, you don't know what you're doing, he's higher, he doesn't have to listen to you. Next thing you know, he's rearing, kicking, and biting, and you're saying the horse is mean, and I have to sell him or give him to meat market. Stop blaming horse. This little guy was really running. He's sweating. He's doing really good with the rope right now. He was very, very nervous before. He's 1 year younger than this guy. I think they're half brothers. Got the same mom. He's going to get in this rope. He may get in trouble. And that's okay. The big guy knows to come to me. Good boy. Easy. Easy. I know. Easy. This little guy's just following him. He's not coming to me. See, as I walk to the middle here and try to draw this guy, the big guy will come. And he'll bring the little guy. But come here, bud. Good boy. But see, the little guy ain't coming. He doesn't learn. So he's learning from the experience. Now, this guy walked off. Good boy. I know. It's okay. So he's going to hang that rope and figure out, you know what? This rope is kind of, I'm not real sure about this rope. I'm a little nervous. See his feet? He's figuring things out, people. The last thing you want to do is protect a horse. You got too many people out there working their horses in barn, listening to these crazy people out here, clinicians saying, buy my tape, buy my this, buy my rope, buy my bit, buy my this. And they don't teach the horse how to deal with their fear. They don't spend enough time sacking out. I'm learning as much about this horse as he's learning about me. I'm learning how he deals with fear, how he reacts. Is he a runner? Is he a kicker? Is he a charger? Is he, see that rope you stepped on? Look, is that a 20 now, man? That's good. See how he's hanging with that horse? And that's okay. I don't want him finding security with me. If that other horse wasn't in here, this horse would do this. I get a lot of questions. I'm trying to lunge my horse and he comes in, he puts his head over me and he won't move. And I got a rope and I got a whip, but I don't want to hit him. And my answer is, well, then he ain't going to run. You need to hit your horse. If a horse chooses how he gets treated. If the horse doesn't want to move, then you have to show him, I can make you move. You have to make it worse to be next to you. Believe me, running is easier than getting hit. So he's going to figure that out pretty quick. But see, too many people don't want to hit their horse, so they get these bad horses, and then the other person, they bring it to someone else so they don't have to do it, and then that person has to hit him twice as much or 10 times as much. I have to be 10 times more aggressive on a horse that's been ruined by somebody loving it. and making it spoiled and mean. So therefore, I got to be the bad guy. But you know what? That's okay, because I know I'm helping a horse. It doesn't help the person. I can make the horse listen to me. That doesn't help the person, because they're going to go back being scared to hit it, being worried. I love it. I don't want it to hate me. I put all these human emotions on it, and then they end up wondering why they don't have a relationship with their horse. So they run around looking on the internet, asking me questions, asking anybody that I'll answer them, trying to buy this video, going to this clinic, going to this expo, trying to find out everything they can, and shortcuts. And instead, if they just put in the time and took the time it takes, it would take less time. People will spend 20 years trying to figure out their horse and making excuses and sending them to trainers and labeling horses, and will keep a horse 20 years, and had they just put in the first 6 months or a year correctly, they would have avoided all that stress, frustration, etc. They'd have a better horse. Them and their horse would both be happier. Okay? So, hope that helps on kind of reading horse a little bit. You can tell the different confidence level. You can tell the insecurity here. Now, when I run these horses, you may think this horse is high horse. Actually, this horse pushes him off. He's younger, but he tells him, get away from me. He's kicked him quite a few times in here. And the big guy is kind of like, okay, he's a little bit more passive. I think if he had to, he would stop him. But he doesn't, because they're buddies. They share a fence. There's a hot wire on a fence. They can't touch each other over the fence. The first time I put them in here together, the owners were like, they're not going to kill each other? Oh, geez. All right, hope that helps. I'll sack it out and kind of using other horses, making horses deal with fear. He's just stepped on that rope. It's tightening around his chest. He's feeling fear. Look at that head. He got stiff. That tail's a little active. That tail's active. I think there's a fly down by his crotch area. But he's dealing with a lot of things. Plus, he sees cattle out here moving. There's a couple people out there walking. They got a lot of things. That's great. Go ahead. Pay attention to a whole bunch of stuff. That means, now, the worst thing I want to do is go over here and try to save this horse and do this. And that's something I've been wanting to cover when I talk about letting a horse walk on a lead rope and teach them that. Where people get in a jam and they teach a horse a bad lesson. When a horse steps on it and struts the rear, they want to rush in and save him and try to help him. That creates pressure, people. If I move in on a horse, it creates pressure. So let the horse figure it out on his own. I don't want to go save this horse. I want this horse to rear, flip over, panic, do it. Look at him, he's yawning. Okay? A few minutes ago, man, when I just picked up that rope, it was like snorting. Now he's going to pick it up. He may bite it. He's like, this stupid rope. This guy's been throwing at me. I ran all this time. I didn't need to. He's really, really just kind of relaxing now. You see his top line. His head's level. Okay? And it's not level because I have a tie down and I'm making it. It's level because he's feeling comfort. He's found comfort by himself because I've let him deal with it. I haven't forced him and put so much pressure. I haven't tried to make him with a bit and a pain. I haven't used a tie down. I haven't used all these martingales or whatever else you want to call these gimmicks out here. I don't buy any of that. I get a lot of questions. What do you think about this? What do you think about Mr. Cook's bitless bridle? Look, all that crap is gimmicks. You get your rope halter and you can ride your horse on a rope halter. Anything else, I want a direct pull. I don't want the things that cross over each other, because when it crosses, it doesn't give release. When you pull on this rein and it crosses underneath his chin, it doesn't release right away when you do. It has to work its way loose so the horse doesn't learn. I don't like things that doesn't give immediate release. That's why I like direct pull. That's why I like rope halters. That's why I like Bozells. It's a direct pull. Now, somebody wrote me, I want to bitless. I got a hackamore, and they had a big old hackamore with 14-inch stinking shanks on it and creating so much more pressure. The only difference is they changed the pain from the mouth to the